I'm honorary service award recipient Narayan Malone, inviting you to 1 month of excitement at the Tangipahoa Hall Parish Library this July. Wow O'Clock, Lady Chop, Shanna Banana, Animal Tales are always crowd favorites. I'll see you this summer in the library.
Why care about downtown? Why does it matter if we have events, shopping, dining? Why? Who cares? Bear with me. I promise I'm getting to a point. You know, we have the mall where I can go to Target, I can get my Starbucks. They make buggies with cup holders now, so I can walk around the store with it. And it's great. I can get everything that I want right there, right? So why downtown? Well, because that Target is the same as every other Target in the country. I can go to Baton Rouge, I can go to Slidell. They're all gonna have a Starbucks, and they're always gonna have fancy buggies so we can walk around with our cup, okay? So what they don't have is Paul's Cafe with pancakes the size of your face. Have you had one? They're huge, okay? What they don't have is CJ's Antiques, where you literally get lost in the antique shop. There's arrows on the floor telling you where to go. They don't have the Country Market, which is our year-round handmade craft market. And I promise you, they don't have an alligator in their store. They might have some Crocs, you know, but they don't have a live alligator. We do. Ponchatoula does. So, okay, so we're different than Target. Great. Well, what about other downtowns? You know, we have our neighbors in Hammond who just won a huge award for the state, which, well, for the country, really. And we're so excited and we're so proud of them. But we're not Hammond either, and we're not Slidell, and they're not us, because what each downtown has is unique to themselves. And that's why Main Street, because we're preserving what we have, what we did have, and what we could have for the future. Because we're not Target, we're not other downtowns, we are our own entity, our own identity, our own culture, history, people, and that's why Main Streets matter, and that's why what we do and the work that we do, the work that our downtown business owners do, that's why we do it, that's why we care. So, kind of continuing to talk about that, I want to, again, indulge me, okay. Who here is a Stranger Things fan? Anyone? Okay. Bear with me. If you're not, I will paint a picture for you. So in season 3 of Stranger Things, I'm not spoiling it, okay? Don't worry if you want to go watch it. But this series is set in the 1980s, so which is when Main Street programs began, okay? In season 3, there's a new, bright, shiny mall that's made, and everyone wants to go there. It's the new hip place. They're walking around in their cool 80s gear, getting all their stuff. That's where all the business is at this point. And in it, you actually see people going to their city hall and saying, "You're killing our downtown, mayor." You know, things are happening, and you go through their downtown, and it's like tumbleweeds basically going through because there's no one going anymore. That, again, that was a TV show, but that's actually what was happening in Main Streets and in downtowns. Historically, downtowns were where all the business was. So just speaking of Tangipahoa Parish specifically, you know, we have our railroad. We were a railroad town, and a lot of Tangipahoa Parish, just our shape, the railroad went right through it. So you really saw that burst of business happening right there because that was where everything came in. They're not gonna come in on dirt roads, right? They're gonna come in on the railroad. So as business kind of centered in that downtown and it continued to grow out, you had highway systems, you had interstates, which are all great for business. You know, we don't want all that riding through downtown, even though they do. But, you know, that is a useful, purposeful invention, these the interstates. And then as the interstates grew, well, now that's where the business went. So, I mean, you can go along any interstate system and you see, you know, big box stores, Buc-ee's, I mean, you know, places like that that's not in a downtown. And so while that was great for them, it was taking all the focus away from your downtown buildings and business owners. And so kind of to keep up with the times, a lot of downtown building owners actually covered up their historic buildings with metal slip covers to give it that big box look. And so when all this change was happening, all this neglect of the buildings, one woman who was a part of this National Historic Preservation Movement, Mary Means, who was a community planner and innovator, she saw what was happening and she said, we have to do something about this. And that was when in 1980, as part of the National Trust for Historic Preservation, the Main Street program became a thing. People started to notice, we're doing this historic preservation work, we're restoring these buildings or we're talking about these buildings, but if no one's in them, there's no economic development going on, what are we doing? What is the point of this? And so she kind of started this off for us. So that is what kind of made people care. So since then, since 1980, Main Street has helped over 2,000 communities across the country bring economic development back downtown while celebrating historic character and bringing communities together. What does all that mean? That is a lot. That's a big job to do. And so what is kind of the phrase that we like to say Main Street is? It's economic development through historic preservation. So it's that combining of the two and bringing economic growth back to your downtowns so we can kind of grow that business but keep that hometown feel, our culture, our history. So how does this happen? How do we do this? So we have our National Main Street Center, our Main Street America program. And so this program, it's encompassing of all the main streets that are in your states and your local municipalities. And in this program, they send us stuff about guides on how to do things. They host conferences for us. Since I've been here, I've only got to go to one national conference, thanks to COVID. But I was in Richmond, Virginia, and so I got to learn new things. I got to experience a new community, see what I really like there, see what maybe I don't like there, and maybe kind of bring that back here. Then you have your state coordinating program. So you have the national, then you have your state. And like every government entity, they're a little understaffed. They're a team of two now, and they are incredible. We actually had a visitor, our assistant director here this morning, meeting with me. I invited her to come, but she couldn't come today. But this team of two travels across the state hosting trainings. We actually have a training coming here in Ponchatoula in just a few weeks. But we host meetings. We'll host tri-state meetings with Louisiana, Mississippi, and Arkansas. So they're really like the boots on the ground for us local coordinating program managers, which is me. So then you have your local coordinating programs located in your municipality. So throughout the state, we have about 34 local programs, and those programs are Ruston, West Monroe, Monroe, Hammond is a part of that, Slidell. There's a few in New Orleans with different areas in New Orleans, but they're everywhere. There's a Homa and a Homer, different places, sound the same. But they're everywhere, and they're still growing. They're still making more Main Street communities. So while we're all in different parts of the world, country, and the state, how do we all work together? How are we following the same program? How do we do what we do? So we actually follow something that the Main Street Center has coined, and it's called a Main Street Approach. And so basically, it's four things that we will work and plan for within these four approaches. So economic vitality, design, promotion, and organization. So I'm going to talk about those briefly, okay? So economic vitality is exactly what you think it would be. It's focusing on the economy in downtown. So helping your new businesses, helping your existing businesses. So a lot of this can be business incentives. So some main streets who may have a separate nonprofit arm, they can actually offer like new business development grants and other business training. So that can kind of fall into that as well. They can have improvement sessions, comprehensive plans, work plans. So that's stuff to actually boost up the economy in that area. Then you have your design, which is what you would expect, enhancing your physical and visual assets. So one example is the state offers a historic restoration grant for your building, which we actually have two recipients of that grant from the previous year, Becky and Marge. They own B2 Time and Again Collectibles. And so what was really, really special about their project, and it was funded with a matching grant from the state, is that the front of their facade, which this building, if you're unfamiliar with where it is now, where Mary's Antiques used to be on the east side of town, the front of the building was crumbling, and I believe it was improper plaster or material. And so what was actually happening was actually happening in Baton Rouge as well. So a building, a state building in Baton Rouge, had the same issue. And so what this grant was able to help them do is they were able to fix that problem, restore the front. They've since painted it, and it looks like a brand new building. It's beautiful. And so that falls into the design elements that we can do. But a part of that is also benches, which we'll be getting benches put in downtown maybe this week or next week. So those will be put in as well. But planters, trees, things that make your landscaping, your buildings a little more attractive, but also restoring the historic quality. Then you have your promotion. So that is really how we center downtown as the hub of the community, the place you want to go. How do we put out a positive image? So that can be just social media or press with our friends with Action News right here, or it can be retail promotions like shopping days, sidewalk sales, or social events like our Live After Five, which is what I want to talk about just briefly about. So we started this Live After Five last Friday. I had no idea what to expect. If you ever plan an event or you're near me at an event, I get very anxious before, because you never know what to expect. You never know how successful it's going to be, and Lord knows it's been raining enough. So it started to drizzle a little bit. We had to kind of work through some kinks. It turned out to be such a successful event. I don't know if any of y'all actually were able to come. Don't worry, we do have more. We're going to release the dates and the bands this week. It was so refreshing to see the families come out. And, you know, a lot of people asked us, we did it in the Strawberry parking lot by City Hall. Why the parking lot? It is hot and this asphalt is just like a pressure cooker. You should have seen how many people walked over to Stray Cats getting daiquiris or Rainbow, right? Yeah. Or the Lacaretta boxes, the drinks from around. I mean, people walking around, they brought their own ice chest, some people. There's really no rule against that, but people just supported the local businesses. So yeah, I could have had it maybe at the park, but would you have walked 3 blocks to get alcohol? Maybe if you're motivated enough. Or dinner, you know, whatever your pick is. But it activated and brought people in a different way. And what was even more refreshing was that I was walking around, because I can't sit still. Standing behind here is killing me right now. But I walked around and I talked to the different groups of people. There was maybe, I'd say, about half people who are from here, or I kind of see faces around, whether they may be on the Strawberry Festival board or just familiar faces. There was a lot of new people. People I've never seen before, families I've never seen. There were two people who came from Houma to come to this. They happened to be in the area, saw it, and they said, well, we do Live After Fives, let's check it out. They were dancing in the parking lot. I never thought I'd see dancing in a parking lot in Punxsutawney, but it was happening, y'all. It was great. I danced a little bit, all right? We did the freeze, okay? So it was a good time, but the amount of people asking questions about what is this program? What is downtown? What do y'all have to offer? There was a couple that I talked to at the end. They've lived here for 2 years and have never came into downtown. They said, I know that y'all have antique shops, you know, and I said, well, we do, but we have a lot of other places too. One of our businesses next week, Mandy May, she's hosting, actually it's this week, I apologize. She's hosting an art opening, an art release. I said, you should check out the art release next week. You know, if you're not doing anything. But I talked to them and they said, wow, well, I want to come back. That's it. That's why we do this. It's because, yeah, you came here to listen to music and it was free and people love free things. I do. But it's going to bring impact that's going to go beyond just coming to listen to music on a Friday night. You're going to maybe see my face or meet another business owner, meet the mayor, he was out there, and get to know him a little bit, or get to know other people and maybe make friends, come back. You're going to feel more comfortable, welcome here. And that's what promotion, that's what we're doing. We're promoting that positive image. And it was a good time. If you came, I hope you had fun. If you didn't, you missed out. But it's okay, you can come back. And then our last point is organization. So that's more of the internal function. So everything else is kind of that external image or promotion, more of the external work. Organization's more of the internal. So that's with volunteers, advisory boards, partnerships. You know, what's really great is that we're building up on a partnership with the Chamber even more this year. We're working on some things hopefully coming up in this near future. But partnership with Tangi Tourism, which we have a tour group coming through just this week that wouldn't have happened without a partnership with Tangi Tourism. Louisiana Main Street, the Division of the Arts. We work with the Punchtula Library, Punchtula High School. Keep Tangipahoa Parish Beautiful. I don't know if anyone has ever been familiar with that. They host cleanups throughout the area, and we've actually had a few in Punchtula just because I said, hey, how do we host that? And now it's another partnership, another opportunity. And of course, all the media, I mean, the amount of media coverage we've got in the last few years, you know, has helped us, has brought our program forward even more. So all of these points really touch on that push for economic development through historic preservation. So, you know, this is what kind of makes that work worthwhile. I've been here for 3 years, and let me tell you, it has not been easy, okay? They don't make a rule book on how to do things in a national global pandemic. I don't know why they wouldn't make that book. Maybe we should now, but they don't. And you know, it's been hard to navigate what that looks like. And then you have a hurricane, and while we may be somewhat of an expert with that, I mean, we were hit really hard. And so these last 3 years haven't been easy, and this work isn't easy anyway. And so tackling on all of that, it is challenging, but the past 3 years have been really successful too. We've had sidewalk sales. We partnered with the library for story walks. We've had 3 since then, and I love seeing the families come through. We've had community cleanup days, like I mentioned earlier, different shopping promotions, a downtown Easter egg hunt, Mother's Day events, Live After 5. And then we help support as well. So the Crew of Aaron has an event coming up, and so they're gonna send me over the information so I can share that on our social media and our website. And so while it might not be our event, we're still supporting that and marketing that. And the same for the events that the Chamber does and any other organization that wants, you know, some of that coverage. And since then, again, we've made great connections with the Punchtula Times, Daily Star, Ken and Cindy, North Shore Broadcasting. I go on the radio every month. It's very weird to hear myself pop up on the radio, but hey, it reaches people, and that's what it's for. Even different stations from Baton Rouge and New Orleans have come here, or I've made connections with, and we've been able to talk about Punchtula and put them on the map in a way. And just for time's sake, you know, we've had different grants, like I said, that's come through, and during COVID, you know, tricky, but trying to be a resource for businesses, for information. We had face masks we got from the state. So I joke to people, I wear so many hats. I don't even think I've worn all the hats that I have to, but I can't make it happen without great business owners and support from the city. And we have an advisory group that has ideas. Actually, our advisory board was the one who came up with Live After 5. And so they gave us the idea, we worked with it, and we made it happen. So, you know, kind of talking about all these different things that we've done, the city has done, exciting things going on in downtown. So it kind of goes back to my Target example. Why Main Street? Why care? Who cares? What happens if we don't care? The businesses care. The people who live here, the people who came to Live After 5 are excited about what we're doing. Grant opportunities, media exposure. You know, when you're looking at a community to live in and to visit, you look at their tourism attractions, you look at their restaurants and their businesses, their parks, their public amenities. Me, I look at downtowns, maybe just because it's my job now and I can't help myself, but I look at what their downtown has, because you learn so much about a community just because of their downtown. You know, we have our Strawberry, we have our Collinswood, our Alligator, you know, we have the Swamp right down the road from us. You learn so much walking around and getting to know people and getting to know where they're from. And so this isn't just, you know, having events. While the events are great and it brings people out, but it's so much more than that. You know, you want to create a space where people want to be, or people want to have fun. You know, seeing the faces of the kids come through, the kids were dancing in the parking lot. Again, it made me a little emotional, I'm not gonna lie. But it was just a beautiful thing to see, people coming together. You know, that's why we do this. It isn't easy, and we don't always do the right things. We're gonna get things wrong, or there's maybe an event that's not super successful. If you would have seen me Friday night, if the event didn't go well, you probably wouldn't want to see me. I probably would have went home not very happy, because it's hard work. There's a lot of work that goes into what we do, what the Chamber does, what Tangi Tourism does, what the city does. But seeing the positive growth and the happy faces and the connections that happen, that's why we do it. It's rewarding. You know, we can't do it alone. If you ever have ideas or you want to get involved, ask me, talk to me after this, message us, because to make our downtown prosper for the future, we need to engage everybody and all act together for that.
Injuries can occur anytime, anyplace, and it may not be your fault. I'm attorney Sherman Mack, and it's my duty to make sure you get the legal representation that you deserve. At the Mack Law Firm, we represent you and your family, and we'll make sure your legal needs are met. Contact us at tangylawteam.com. Our team is ready to help.